Good morning, everybody. Saturday morning, and I am actually just opening up my M&M order I made and seeing what I'm going to keep. And I've also got a ton of stuff I brought from the office that I want to start trying. So I've got a big mess here that I thought I would clear up with you. So where am I going to start? I've got so much to sort. You can just see how messy life is. Hold on. I've just got these bags here full of stuff. I've got these vitamins I'm doing. I've got a mess here. I've got a mess here. You know me and my messes. And I'm feeling that sense of a mess right now. Some new vitamin supplements I'm trying, which I love. Okay, the best thing. I'm on day two. I don't know if you saw on my live the other day, I went to see a really old facialist, sort of weird woman. Vivian will hate me saying that, but anyway, she always picked me up and looked after me when I had was exhausted in my life or my skin was bad in the last sort of 10-15 years actually. And so I got in touch with her again because I thought I'm losing weight, I'm getting healthy, not so much losing weight. Now what I want is I want to be toned and I want to get rid of that kind of saggy. Let me just show you. Okay, I'm just gonna do this, right? I won't show you everything, but just get an idea here of that. There's a lot of sagging here, and I want to get that sort of tight and well, and I feel my legs are not quite the tone they used to be. So I want to change the texture of the skin on my body, and I'm exercising to get fit on my body. So I went to see her. Because I went on this machine ages ago she used to do where she just made this machine where she puts all these pads on your legs, but she puts them on very specific lymphatic areas. So it helps drain your lymph better. And I've got cleavers I'm on from Shabir for my lymph, but I felt I needed something else. Sorry, I forgot to put deodorant on this morning. So she made this powder. And I love this powder, I know it's gonna help me. It comes in two or three different types. This is silver blend, there. I've got platinum blend too, but it's full of ingredients that are gonna help hormonal skin, for want of a better word. The silver one is any old hormonal skin, meaning you can do it when you're 30. The platinum, I think, is for menopausal women, and it has got in it, I mean, it's got brilliant things in it that I'm not going to remember now, but just trust me, I looked at all the ingredients. I looked at the ingredients with Natalie as well. And she said, this is great, my trainer. So I'm gonna take one big scoop, and it's a huge scoop I take in the morning, and I'll take a scoop of this at night. It shouldn't substitute food or anything, but it's really going to help with my skin. And then I've been microneedling on my body. So for the tone, I'm microneedling, and I'm using the Swiss Clinic needle, or, well, that was the one I found, the Swiss Clinic needle. Not 0.5. And then afterwards, I'm putting on either the Julia Hunter like that, which is the exfoliator, which is actually her original face and body exfoliating peel, which you don't take off again. But then she just came out with these, which are Whole Body Renew, and they're pads, exfoliating body pads. Smell like weird, but they are sort of just taking off my dead skin, and I'll put them on when I've had a shower and done some needling. Just went past in a dressing gown, and they're working well. So that skin tone. So I'm on a body mission, and then you know I always do my pinching and my, you know, I talked about this a little bit, just how we massage our arms and really get that third finger in there and make a movement with our arm. That's very important. Other simple little things I'm doing, whenever I'm brushing my teeth or doing a skincare routine, I'm just doing a few little squats or bends, well, those are squats. Just keep my body moving all the time. That's the idea. So, yes. Okay, new little skincare things I want to talk about for 5 minutes, and then I'll show you my M&M order, and you can tell me what you think I should keep. But I did this routine this morning. I'm going to show you again what I did. It was a sort of intense, I've got to think where I started, because I really liked it. I love layering products. Vitamin C and the vitamin C paste. Yes. I'm going to take off my top. Am I going to take off my top? No, because like, you'll see I'm not high enough up. All right, I'll just show you. Lixia. Don't know if I should keep this top. The orange is a bit of a, the pink's a bit of a funny colour. Good morning. So, Lixia vitamin C paste, which you put on after you've cleansed your skin. And you're meant to wash off, I think. But I put this on, it smells weird. Lixia is a range developed by the woman who did Ren. And it really is a weird smell. But I put that on, and then I put on some vitamin C powder on top of that, like this, that much powder, which I rub in to my cheeks. And I got this idea because when I was having a facial with Vivian 2 days ago, she used this Kate Berkey, who does very, very natural ingredients. And she, at some stage of the facial, she put on extra vitamin C and I felt it was a powder and she really rubbed it in. So if you're thinking my skin is looking very dull today, you could consider getting the vitamin C paste from Lixia, getting extra vitamin C powder, and then just having a real rub into your skin. You can keep the vitamin C paste on for a little bit. It does work if you keep it on for longer. And this is really for waking up to a tired, dull day. The vitamin C paste I got from Liberty, they sell it also on Victoria Health. I think it was like 30 something pounds. And the extra intense pure milled vitamin C powder is Julia Hunter, which I get from America. I get it directly from her site, Skin Therapy. If you buy over 5 products, they give you 25% discount. So I generally wait and then stock up an order. So I'm gonna take that mask off, and you could just take it off, I think. You know, it's something that can penetrate in. It's not going to have too much water. So I'm just gonna take that off now. And a cloth to dry it. So messy on here, I'm embarrassed to show you. But if you just show it in the sun. Can you just see? It's just, my skin feels fresh. A brand, if you have any issues around sensitive skin, an amazing brand. There are some days when some of you say you've got a really red skin or sensitive skin, or you've had a laser treatment that hasn't worked. That I've just got another one back in my bathroom. It's clinical, amazing dermatologist group of doctors who made these products, and it's a shield. And if you've got scarring, if you've just had an operation and you want the scar to heal, it goes literally, it's the only thing that can go on a really new scar, and it just goes in and has smells of nothing, has great ingredients, very healing. They also have for pigmentation Hydrocool serum, which is amazing. I'm trying at the moment. I love. So you just do a little bit on pigmentation areas. It's, I think it's been very good in the summer because it has a menthol coolingness to it. Very good as well, this range for really sensitive skin. Just go and look at the whole range. Sold on Victoria Health, but sold on its site too. Oh, this is another great product. If any of you are going away on a long flight, let me just try and push that baby back so it hears me. On a long flight, this is what I use, and I cover my face in it as a barrier cream on a flight, and I will arrive even after a flight to Australia with amazingly plump skin. This is like the Nirvana. There's definitely emu oil in it because this was formulated originally cosmetics by Julia Hunter, who does those other things I like, but she left the company. But some of her formulations stay, because I can smell in that. There's a certain smell to the recovery balm. You can see it is sort of greasy looking. When you put that on a plane, you've got to imagine this is an entire barrier and you're just gonna have that on. So, love that product, one of my favorite products. Right, eyes, now I've just these other things that I'm, oh, here. Miracle Facial Oil from Evolve. I'm just gonna try it. Because as I love everything from this brand, I got some more things to try. We can do a little morning facial massage. Ready? To the music. So get a facial oil in your hands, warm it up. You don't need to do this, but I've always had a habit of heating it in my hands. I can smell a little bit of the product that's in the cleansing balm. So I just always start off and I do, just get it on my skin. And you could do some lymphatic drainage. I'm not going to go all the way down because I've got my top on. But this is a movement I really enjoy. Vivian does this movement on me when she does her facial, which I will show you one day. But it's just that real quick pushing your skin up. It gets such a good workout on your arms as well. And just, I'm sort of going under here like that, but I'm doing it really quickly. I'm following my cheekbone round and bringing it up. And my arms are so getting a workout. So there, go over there. So under there and over there. Then I might do a little pinching like that. And I don't mind that redness at all. I want that redness. I want that stimulation of the skin. And then I'm sort of pinching around my cheekbone area. It's a little sort of pinch and twist. I'm doing this movement. Like that. And then I'll go back to a bit of that. And then I'll go and do some scissoring like this around my eyebrows and just under so I can get that skin between my eye and my eyebrow toned because we don't do it enough. My arms are so tired. If you're doing it with me, are you feeling tired arms? I'm now as red as my top. And then I'm just going to do this. For those of you who might sleep worrying, just unworry your face. Unworry your face, unworry your face. Unworry your face, ladies. Saturday morning, beautiful day. What are your plans today? If you've got lots of lovely things to do. If you're in Australia, I hope you've had a lovely day. You've had good weather. Wherever you are in the world, if you're just waking up in America very early, hope you have a lovely weekend. It's Mother's Day in England this weekend, which is a commercial holiday. Some people love it, some people don't. But it's kind of, for those people who maybe have a sweet mother and they neglect their relationship with their mum, it's a day to, I suppose, put the focus on your mum. Some of us have complicated relationships with our mothers. We love them, but we might have had a difficult time as we're growing up. I would put myself in that category. But it taught me a lot about my relationship and how I want to have a relationship, what kind of relationship I want to have with Lila. But I'm gonna see my mum tomorrow with Lila. We're taking out my mum and her best friend from her home and take them out to lunch. Okay, there we go. All right, that's it. Little morning massage. Did you do some with me, ladies? Oh, take off the excess. And I'm going to put on, I'm carry on with Evolve because it's a good price range. And this is their Multipeptide 360 Moisture Cream. I like the way they labeled it for dry skin with Kupaku, Prickly Pear, which is such a great product, natural peptides and hyaluronic acid. You know what I feel about the wrong hyaluronic, so let's see. I tried this on my live last week and I did do one side of my face with a SkinCeuticals product and the other side with this. It goes on beautifully, by the way. There's no sort of emollients that are taking a while to rub in. It rubs in immediately. Very interestingly, it's going on really well after that oil. I think one reason, one of the only reasons to stick with a similar label for a whole regime is that you otherwise will find some products don't work over facial oils. And if you have a range which has a facial oil in it, you know that product will sit on top of the facial oil and won't pell. So, okay, so my skin might be red, my hair might be really shockingly bad this morning, but my face feels well. Should we be vigorous with our skin? It's so personal. I am. And I think I have been, because I've had very bad skin, which has given scar tissue on my skin, which means it's quite tough and it can put up with a lot. But some people need to be very delicate with their skin because they might have quite a thin skin, and you know, they can just gently touch it, gently. So let me just try now. Let me practice the art of gentle touching. I'm putting SPF on because I did a peel on Thursday. So I'm using BFF, putting quite a lot on. Okay. If you want to do that massage, you can do it in a much more sensitive way. You needn't copy my vigorousness, but just do something to stimulate your skin, that's what I'd say. I am now going to do a little bit of redder on my under eye. I just do, I live with BFFI now. It is, to me, one of the most fantastic products that we make, because it does that combination of clearing up a dark circle and acting as an eye cream on your skin. So you don't need two products, you just use one. And it really clears. I don't know if you noticed that I did have slightly dark circles today. It's difficult light here, but it is remarkably improved as soon as I put that on. It doesn't crease, I've slept in it. And I wear redder. When you're looking at the color that's right for you, do trust Match to Me, because we kind of believe you should put on a concealer under your eye that really, really, really suits you tonally. I'm just sorry, I'm trying to find my foundation, which isn't here. I've got nothing here of my... I did do one stack that I got ready. I thought I had everything in it, but let's see. Yes, okay, so I'll just do a little here. So just a touch for me is something I put in a different place from BFFI. I put it around areas of redness. I put it around my nose. Like that. There. I've got no unevenness of skin tone. And then I'm going to do some... Oh, do I have it? Oh my God. Oh my God. Do I have my Miracle Blur? Oh my goodness. You know what? Miracle Blur's out of stock and I can't find mine. I'll do face finish, but I have Miracle Blur. So Miracle Blur, which is back in stock next week. You have 7,000 people on the wait list. But look, here, I've got those lines. I put it in there, where I got lined. Oh, I love this. Don't you love this? Don't you love this? So I go in where the pores are big, and it will just cover any big pores and lines. And I fill it in like polyfiller, like that. And then where you've got kind of pebble chin, put it in like that, and it fills it in. Huh. Back in stock next week. Please put your name on the wait list, because we ordered 10,000, but I just know with sort of that many people on the wait list, it might sell out again quite quickly. Okay, so I just put it like that. Do you see my around my... how much better that is around there. And then if you've got really oily, you can put it at the top, otherwise do face finish. I think today I want to put on, with the pink, I want to put on some Mama, actually. What do I want to put on Katia? I've got Katia here. It would be really good if I actually had Katia here, I did. Okay, I'm gonna put on Mama. There. See how that works. Do we like that, those colours together? Quite like it. I just feel with the strengths of this top, I need a bit more pink. So I'm going to put a bit of cordial on top of that. I've got some. Of course I haven't. Oh, yes, I have. I'm going to put some cordial. A bit of matchy-matchy. Yeah. I think that's better. And then I'll put a little bit cordial on top of my mama. Like that. A wash of Dahlia. How does that look? Ooh, kind of weird. Kind of interesting too, just to have that wash there. Yes, I quite like that. You see it was a bit poppy on the eye. I'll put a bit of Talik eyelash conditioning gel on. My eyelashes are quite strong at the moment, so I need to have something to balance them out. So I've got to put some colour on the bottom. So I'm going to take, there's Emperor. So I'm just going to take a little bit under my eye, just to bring together that heavy, strong lash, which I might change soon actually. I'm suddenly feeling it's too strong today. Going underneath, I'm doing it very roughly because I'm going to then fuzz it all in there. So it's really, you can tell that's really rough. And then I'm going to take my fuzzing brush. I'm just going to give a little bit of smokiness and fuzz everything out, staying high, and then fuzz up there. But it's just making my eyes pop a bit. There. And I'll go back to that Talik eyelash conditioning gel. There. I'm going to end with something I love. Okay, so this is my hair at the moment, which is just a bit, you know, that old-fashioned dull Sam McKnight. There's about four of them, but I bought this one because there was a mini one as well in Liberty's. And I'm just going to turn my head upside down and spray it in. It's like a hair texturizer. The smell is delicious. But I'm just going to scrunch it a bit, like this. A bit more scrunching. And I'll put it over my face. And it's given me hold, but it hasn't given me, you know, it doesn't feel like I can't put my fingers through it. Bloody brilliant. So if I was sitting my boss now and I'd say, what's my skincare regime I love? It would be any cleanser that of any ones I mentioned. Definitely Claire's toner, which I love, or the exfoliating toner by P50 as a sort of stage. Always, 90% of the time, vitamin C by C Ferulic, but I could do the skin paste, so a vitamin C. Then a serum to treat something. So if your skin feels dry or dehydrated, one kind of serum. So different serums treat different things. A serum and then a nice moisturizer. And then things I add in are masks, and then I add in some vitamins and supplements and everything. Okay, a new thing. My memory. Maybe because I go at 1,000 miles an hour, my memory is not great. My mother has Alzheimer's, which has vascular dementia. And even though these might be nothing that are going to help vascular dementia, I'm very aware to do things where I get, I still have a good memory and I'm not reaching for words, which I can find myself doing when I'm stressed. And years ago, I went to the Wellington Hospital because I felt I'm really not remembering. I was very stressed. And the guy said to me, I might be saying it medically incorrect now, but he said to me, when you're really stressed, the stress, the cortisol, whatever, but all those stress things that are going on inside your brain sit in your short-term memory space, so they eat into your ability to retain your short-term memory. So the less stressed you are, the more fully evolved your short-term memory can be, and the better it can work. It made sense to me, even if that's not medically 100% correct for people who are watching, it really made sense for me to say, dial down the stress, the memory gets better. But then I also want supplements that will help that, and I am now trying. Nubia Spark, specifically for those looking to support their memory. There's so many things in it. I've got to check I'm not doubling up on things, but I like the idea of this. I'm going to check it against my powder and see if I can take both things. but I'm definitely washed. I'm thinking about that cajun too now. Okay, I could show you quickly. I got before now. This pink jacket, which is what inspired me to get the matching, I mean, I could be an airline stewardess, but there's something I like about the matchingness of that outfit with the white button and the what, hang on, gotta hold up, and the white trainer. But what I would do with this is it's got this sort of stretchy skirt, which I don't like, so I think it makes it look cheap. So I'm gonna actually put it's in pink. I might put nude underneath. I don't want to have that hard line, and it's too thin for me to show it. So I've got to resolve that. Otherwise, I'll be sending it back. And then also, I don't suit that neckline at all. So what I do is I always turn my M&M tops in because I have more than one of these. I got each season, I've got them. And then I do it up inside the, so do it up inside the, try to do this inside the collar. It's not gonna work. When you're doing things back to front, it's really tricky. Oh, yes, I am going to do it. So I get then, I just prefer that. I feel that's more chic as a neckline. So that's that one. I also got to try, I have the skirt in yellow, and I thought it might be interesting with my Zara yellow jacket. So I'm just going to see if the colour's the same. There, that's great. I was thinking of that with that jacket. Do you see? And it does actually work. I love tonality, so I might do a whole yellow look with that skirt. And then I've just got to sort out the lining. But you can see the full length thing now. Just get that down so you can see that properly. Really, I am like a piece of chewing, I mean a piece of bubble gum. And then you know what I'll probably do? I'll probably put a white bag with it. This might be too much. This is from Essentials Antwerp, which is a store I love. It opened up in Sloane Square on the weekend. Oh shit! Fell into my own cupboard. Yeah, so I started to look. Ladies, have a great weekend. I'll catch up maybe tomorrow. It is Mother's Day tomorrow, so you're going to be busy with your mums. I don't know if I'll do a live. But just, you know, it's a lovely day. If you haven't got dressed yet and I've made you late, go and put on some joyous colour. And if you don't normally wear colour, challenge yourselves to some colour. Be inspired by a bit of colour. I do this now. This is my cupboard. All right, and most of this is from the high street. And that just, every morning when I'm faced with that, it makes it very hard for me to say, let me wear black. So if you have time this weekend, think about rearranging your wardrobe to really have colour. So if I look at all, this is all colour. I'm going to show you another one, just to show you how much we love colour. That's colour. You know, there's colour, colour, colour. Then I've done all my tops in colour, colour, colour. Okay. And then this I got to sort out, but just everywhere I look, I want to see colour. Okay, let's get it. Let's get colour into life. Send you kisses. Have a good weekend.